Okay, so moving on to this. I got these Shibari ropes, and there's a girl on my Instagram who she follows me. And I started following her back. Actually, this is her craft here. And it was something that she was doing specifically as a healing technique. However, I actually really enjoyed like the idea of the art of tying this, especially like tying it in with central movement and stuff. I thought that this would be kind of a unique, interesting, and I don't know, an interesting spin on some sort of healing. All right. So I was wondering how this was going to come, like what it was gonna come in, because the website says like kink toys, and I'm like, oh shit. Anyways. So I got three ropes and some safety scissors. This is not for you. So I ordered the rope in gold. There was multiple different colors that you could get. Oh, so it's called Agreeable Agony is the name of the place where I got this from. And so it says unique handcrafted kink toys, bondage rope, wax play candles, books and accessories, floggers and dragon tails, pedal slappers and jacks, claws and jewelry. So if you're into it, get into it, you know? Anywho, some of that stuff, I don't know what it is, but it's all good. So there's these big gigantic scissors. I guess these are safety shears. So needless to say, we have the scissors. And then I have three 30-foot ropes. So I'm gonna clip in like a little example of what you actually do with this, or what you can do with this, or the possibilities of what you can do with this. They're probably freaking endless. But I don't know, I'm like trying to get into it. So let me show you that right now.
So this one here was my favorite. It's kind of like a leg self tie. And then this is how it would be worn, basically as kind of like rope lingerie. And then I actually thought this was crazy dope, like on the pole. That was unique. This was another one, like a different kind of tie and harness. And then this one gets a little bit more into the kink. But this is the original video that I saw that set it off for me. Because my anywho, that was on Instagram, and that's the video that made me go, interesting.
Oh my god, like it feels so good though. Like it's definitely not, I feel like it looked like jute cord or something, like, but it's not. It's like super silky. It feels really nice. So in terms of like sensual context, like to my fingers, this rope feels really good. But like on the videos, so I don't know anything about this. The girl that I ordered it from, I told her that I was interested and that I was gonna order some, and then she offers like this consultation and this class on like how to tie it and stuff, and apparently there's classes on how to do this and everything. It's like a whole community of a thing. But anyway, essentially you put it on and you like make these ties, I guess,
in some kind of way, y'all. I don't know, this is completely incorrect. I'm sure
that's way too long. Well, okay, that's way too long. Can I do it the other way? And then you pretty much like tie yourself up. I don't know, part of the reason I wanted it is because I feel like once you're all tied in it a certain way, it makes like a really cute like lingerie kind of look. And so I think my creative brain is going, I'm thinking in terms of just like pictures and like pictures that express a level of sensuality or a level of comfort and confidence in the body and things like that. I thought it'd be really cool to make some unique like little shibari rope outfits. I don't know, it's an interesting technique that I would like to try. So if you're wanting to see the updates on that journey, you may want to follow my Instagram. Both Instagram links are in the description box below. It's probably something I may share on TikTok. I'm not really sure, but yeah, so this is my shibari. This is my rope. I had gotten heavily back into pole dancing and sensual movement about a year ago, a little after we moved to the Las Vegas house. And really just remembering why I even got into it in the first place and why I love it so much and just the change that it literally can make for you, not only just to the physical body as far as like getting stronger and, you know, losing inches and toning the body and things like that, but essentially tapping into the body and honing in and really just making and creating space to show up for yourself, show up on your mat the same way you would any other practice. Any other practice, yoga, you go to dance class, if you play sports, piano, if you're a musician, if you write, like anything, like anything that your energy pours into. So that's been really nice getting back into that. And I've been wanting to get into back into like studio classes, taking classes by other instructors. I've joined a couple of Patreons where I've been able to learn some things. Because the teacher should not stop learning. You know, I'm forever a student of sensual living. And so one more little thing to add to the toolbox of unique and interesting healing modalities, non-traditional things that we use to
essentially heal ourselves and tap back into the body and come into a space of presence. Well, it's a great time to start our reading because we haven't done that yet. So we'll go ahead and jump right in for today, August the 5th.
So for August 5th, it says, the gift of sacred idleness. Work is not always required. There is such a thing as sacred idleness, the cultivation of which is now fearfully neglected. George MacDonald. It was a gorgeous summer morning, sunny, but not too hot or humid. The kind of day that should make you feel grateful to be alive, but I was too exhausted to acknowledge the gift. All night I'd tossed and turned, drifting in and out of consciousness, but not really sleep. With a work deadline looming, the end of summer camp, but another month to go before school resumed, and the need to visit my sick mother, I had a new appreciation for what the English poet Stevie Smith meant when she confessed that she was not waving, but drowning. Letting the cats into the backyard, I stepped out for a brief moment. A refreshing breeze rustled the green branches. Sun-dappled patterns of light and shadow created a lovely mosaic on the grass that I'd never noticed before. A natural concerto, birds singing, cicadas chirping, bees buzzing, resonated early in the morning stillness. The hush of harmony hovered around me. I didn't want to leave. Reluctantly, I went inside to get a start before Katie woke up. But the sight of my books and papers sprawled all over the floor near my bed where I'd wearily flung them the night before gave outward expression to my inner chaos and overwhelmed me, and I burst into tears. After I'd had a good cry, the gentle, reassuring voice that I'd come to know as Spirit suggested that I return to the backyard. Oddly enough, instead of protesting, I did. I spread an old cotton bedspread on the ground, borrowed pillows from the living room love seat, and propped them up against a tall oak tree, creating a chaise lounge on the earth. I then carried out my tea tray, my work basket, assuming I was settling outside to write. But when I sat down, all I could bring myself to do was quietly sit and breathe slowly. I didn't want to meditate, have an authentic conversation with anyone, think, create, be clever, or be a conduit. So I just sat there, sipped tea, looked up at the blue sky through leafy canopy overhead. And observed a butterfly's graceful path through the garden. My surroundings were ordinary, but this morning, so beautiful, so familiar, and yet so different. Within a few minutes, my dark mood began to lift. Soon the cats joined me, curious at this unusual detour in my day's rhythm. A little while later, Katie wandered out, still drowsy with sleep, carrying a blanket and a pillow to the nest and read with us. She asked what I was doing. I told her, for want of a better explanation, that I was conducting research, letting Mother Nature nurture so that I could write a meditation. I invited her to join me. Because Mom seemed so calm and receptive, she decided to seize the day and asked me to sort through the boxes of her baby memorabilia. Who knew how long this unusual opportunity would last? Well, it lasted for 8 lovely summer hours and included an al fresco lunch as well as a nap. In between laughter, family stories, confidence sharing, animal watching, and dreaming aloud, I did absolutely nothing at all except live and love. At the end of this simply abundant day of bliss, I realized that I'd been given a restorative gift, sacred idleness, an unexpected melodic day of undoing to balance the disordinate days of doing too much. Like grace, this blessing had come out of the blue. It was completely impractical, but absolutely necessary, and it was savored with thanksgiving. Sacred idleness, that time that you spend doing absolutely nothing, enjoying the beauty of just nature around you, being harmonious, like drawing yourself back into a place of stillness. And it really does. It really is restorative. It really is really very helpful. But I like how she says about the English poet Stevie Smith, who says, I'm not waving, I'm drowning. It sounds like the person who seems like they always have it together from the outside and they've got everything on point and everything going on. And, you know, everybody's thinking that they're doing like this, saying hi, that, you know, got it together. Yes. And it's like, in actuality, it's like, somebody fucking help me. So I can appreciate that. Check on your strong friends. But that was a good one. So the gift of sacred idleness for August 5th today. And it is currently 11:30. We have Miss Lala here today. She cleans every other Friday, so she's cleaning. So we're probably going to figure out a way to get out of her way and go outside and find something to do. Maybe go grab some breakfast or brunch or lunch or I don't know, and then carry on with the day. Having some kind of a freaking problem, like they're just always in a hectic uproar, like lunchtime. From McDonald's, we went to McDonald's. They're always having some drama inside of the McDonald's. Like literally, I was probably standing there for like 15 minutes before anybody even took my order. But we went to McDonald's, we went to the park. The kids only got to play for probably like 20 minutes maybe. And then they had to go to the restroom. The park doesn't have bathrooms and we were walking. So it's maybe like a quarter of a mile or something like that from the park to the house, if even that. But we had to walk home in order for them to be able to use the bathroom. So we ended up leaving. And I've just been hanging out. I was actually messing around with my shibari ropes a little bit and trying some ties that I seen on YouTube and just trying to see. I was just anxious to see. I'm gonna have an actual class with somebody, but I was excited to get started. And so now I'm sitting down doing what I do all the time, charts. And that's probably how I'm going to spend my Friday night, is playing around with astrology and working on some charts that I have in front of me. For I have one for my sister and one for a friend, and then there's still just other charts of my own that I want to do, and it's just a lot. So that's gonna be it. I'm gonna go ahead and end this one here, and I will catch up with you guys tomorrow. It is the weekend. Woohoo! Last couple of days, so the kids around here go back to school next week. We don't start our homeschool yet for another few weeks, but I definitely want to start winding things into more of a routine in the grind, so we'll start getting into some more of those type of videos as that comes up for me. So I will see you guys later. Have a really wonderful Friday night, and I'll catch you tomorrow.
Thanks for hanging.